What are they, Elizabeth?
Goatskin bellows.
Phu, from the monastery.
Of a three-day puja ceremony where gifts are offered to the gods. Burials are in fact comparatively rare amongst the Bosha, so concerned are they that the spirit of the dead person may linger on in the body, or even in the body of somebody living, and they usually destroy the corpses. The bodies of children under 8 are buried as a matter of course. Most of the other corpses are either burnt or, more commonly, dismembered and fed to the vultures, a grisly spectacle that we witness later on. The body is kept in the house for 3 days while the last rites are carried out. The period between death and disposal of the corpse can be as much as 4 days if the lamas believe that the spirit is loath to quit its body. The sight and sound of the village women in traditional clothes singing and chanting was truly an unforgettable experience.
Can you just explain what this is?
This is the 5 different kind of fair flags. They have to take a colour to the funeral. And it's each colour has like white...
What's that?
It's the body.
That's the body in the basket?
Yeah.
Walking along the high ridge along the west side of the valley that we've entered the Phu region by.
How far have we climbed?
We've climbed about 2,000 feet, I think. We're walking to about 15,000 feet. Very cold in the wind. We're in Phu Nar. It's about 14,000 feet.
Cool. What's going on with the campsite?
We're camping in a very small area and it's not very flat either.
Our tent is the one perched on the back on the ridge. We had a constant night of constantly pushing ourselves up and slipping down. So today's route is down into the gorge and then up with a 3,000 foot climb from where we hope to get some spectacular views.
Just take me 2 hours to climb up 500 feet to 17,500. God, I've just put my hand in some snow leopard dung
and you can see overlooking here, you're looking over towards Tibet, and these are the mountains that we did the horse riding round over here a couple of days ago. Looking over here, over here this is the valley that we walked down. It took us 2.5 days to walk down to Phu. And looking over here is Kangaroo, and a stupid place to put bird tables. And if you come right over this way, you can just about see the fishtail mountain in the Annapurna sanctuary. And that facing us is Annapurna.
I've just had to have an hour's rest down there because I was feeling listless, slurring my speech, feeling sick. And feeling faint, but apart from that I'm all right. It'd be interesting to interview the rest of the party that come up as they reach the ridge.
Looking at the campsites which we reached last night after an epic walk, the view from the bedroom window is fantastic of Pisang Peak in the distance, and we're looking also down towards Nar village. We were glad to arrive here after the most appalling descent over scree that seemed to go on forever. One began to think that the campsite was like the land of green ginger. Just when you thought you were getting there, it disappeared and went over another hill. The walk was quite something. We were the first Europeans to cross a vast pass, nameless, thank God, and we'll probably be the last Europeans to cross it as well. It was scree and loose rock, and I felt like death, and I think we all did, and I think we were all quite relieved to learn that today, despite an awful river crossing that's coming up, we're going straight to Nar and not to Chulu East Base Camp, because I think we're all a bit knackered. But it was a challenge yesterday, and looking back on it, glad as I am that it's over, it was quite an achievement. Very pleased. We're now looking up to the hills that separate the Phu region from the Nar region. We're now in the Nar region. I shouldn't think many animals get from Phu to Nar over that pass. Maybe the odd goat and the odd mad human being.
Right, the pass yesterday, apparently Hillary was the first Western woman to cross the summit, and Juliet second, and I was apparently the second man to cross this summit, Nigel being the first 45 minutes earlier, but I'm the only Western man to cross it on his hands and knees. Here we are in Nar, and the first kids to come towards us.